So this list is from Twitter. I'm going to find out exactly whose deck it was. I noticed this deck on Twitter. The sideboard is random from what I had before myself. I did see this deck on Twitter where the person posting it said that they exclusively play best of one and they made the number one rank on the arena ladder, which I think is a really cool accomplishment. Dang, elves. All right, here's the deck. It comes from Andrew Schneider. Relax MTG on Twitter. That's where the list comes from. Andrew, if I understand it correctly, exclusively plays best of one. So this is a best of one list where I guess you take advantage of the fact that your opponents don't really have sweepers. It's probably more of an aggressive format. People probably play, you know, blue-white auras and like these kind of decks where you just kind of focus on your own thing. So there really is no sideboard. I did have a green-black elves list build before. If you do want to splash a color, you can splash black. You're going to get Blossom, the new fast land, the one from Kaladesh that comes into play untapped if you have three or less lands. You have Overgrown Tomb and the Woodland Cemetery. So you can very easily splash black if you want to. Black gives you Thoughtseize, which is great against like the combo decks, for example. You can splash white, which gives you Rest in Peace, for example, really good against the graveyard decks. But you can also just play, you know, Scavenging Ooze is a great card because you can hit it in Collecting Company. Same thing with Reclamation Site. So if you want to build a sideboard, it's pretty easy. This deck should be fine for best of three as well, but you should expect like a lot of, you know, sweeper kind of cards in best of threes. People are going to have Cry of Carnarium. They're going to have Extinction Event. They're going to have all these kind of cards. So best of one is probably better for this list. Yeah, it's just classic elves. You have a lot of mana creatures. You kind of go wide and then you win with some big spell. Usually it's something like Court of Calling. In this case, it's Crater of Behemoth. A lot of the early dorks just give you extra mana. They can get bigger with Archdruid and Clan Caller. You can also win with Shepherd sometimes. I thought this deck wasn't all that great when I tried it myself. I actually felt that I burned 20 wild cards building this and then didn't really have a lot of success with it because the deck really does miss Elvish Mystic. Like, if you play this in Pioneer or Modern or Legacy, you have eight Llanowar Elves, basically. Llanowar Elf and Elvish Mystic. And that's a really, really big difference. Because this deck, if you just start on turn two, that's just not good enough. And this is not, like, a very impactful turn one play. Like, this is good on turn four when you already have, you know, a million mana and you can attack with a bunch of creatures. But it's not a very impactful turn one play because you really do need the extra mana to ramp up very fast. So Gilded Goose, it's okay, but you can only really get the mana once. Like, then you have to recharge it, then it's kind of slow. So that's not all that great. So it's kind of just Llanowar Elf. And yeah, if you draw Llanowar Elf, the deck feels great. If you don't, then I don't love it that much, but it's hard to argue with Andrew's success. Because getting to the number one rank does take quite a lot of games. So you can just, you know, randomly win 10 games in a row and just be like, okay, you know, I got to the top. Like, you do need to play a million games. So I'm gonna give this a spin in the best of one historic queue. Historic ranked. Best of historic elves. All right, let's go. You have to spend a lot of wild cards on this deck. That's the only problem. Like, there's so many cards from Jumpstart, and you do have to spend a lot of rares and mythics on it. That is the only downside of the Zelves deck. Okay, this is sort of the actual best hand. This looks like Red Black Lurus or Blue White Auras. Okay, so that is probably Blue White Auras. This guy. Now we have all the mana in the world, we can cast Company. find like an Archdruid or a Fierce Empath. The reason why Behemoth is really cool in this deck is because you can find Fierce Empath in this, and that finds you Behemoth. And you don't have to play the Green Finale. Can I cast both Company and... Yeah, I can, right? I should have played the castle, I think, but it's not really going to matter too much. Yeah, let's cast Company. Is there a way for me to attack still this turn? Probably not. I'm just going to cast it now. I don't want to get, like, Spell Pierced or something. Like, people sometimes play those cards in the blue-white deck, so I'm not going to wait with this. There's no real reason to do it. Plus, now I get this guy in play. Pay. Yeah, we're going to have a lot of mana, and we're going to get more Clan Callers. This gives me 4 mana already. How much mana do I have next in 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 pretty much. Gain some life, sure. Could they even attack? Yeah, I'm not gonna block. I'm gonna make my creatures really big. Like, basically now I'm just waiting for Behemoth or Fearsome Path or another company. And if that doesn't happen, then I can just get a bunch of these. Dwinen's Elite is good. I should have used the castle. No, I'm not going to be able to attack with... Should have used the castle. I would have been able to attack with more creatures, I guess. I guess I can just stab the 5-5. It also works. Yeah, it's going to be the same thing. Okay, never mind then. Yeah. So, this does this... Yeah. So I have mana to activate this and make food from ooze. I can chump this with a token or something. Yeah, I don't know how they're gonna beat this. Like, they certainly can. They can make their guy unblockable and like put the plus X on it for each enchantment and stuff like that. But I am going to be attacking for a lot of damage here very soon. Food can make me a food. Goose can make me a food token. Frogify. Sure. It is still going to be an 8-8 though. It's just not going to give me as much mana. Wait, how is it a 6-6? Oh, it's not an elf. Okay. I see. It's not an elf. That's why it loses the +2/+2. Normally, if you put a card like Frogify on a creature with counters, the counters still count. Like, it doesn't matter. So, like, it was a 1-1 previously with counters. It is still a 1-1 with counters. So, that doesn't change. It just loses the creature type, so it's not an elf. So, that's why it doesn't get the +2/+2. Well, there's the unblockable thing. The question is, can they even attack? I don't even think my opponent can attack. They're going to take a lot of damage next turn. 21, block the 6 power guy. Okay, so what is happening? Block the 6 power guy. I have to tap this to search for another one. Then I can't sack food unless I keep two creatures back. Can I attack for lethal? They block this and they take 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 21. I think they do. Wait. Let's see. I really hope I didn't miscount. Four, five, nine, 12, and nine is 21, and they block the 6/6. Oh, I could have used the goose. Oh, I'm so dumb. I mean, it worked out anyways, but I could have used the goose. Yeah. I didn't really even try to count the goose because the first count I did just worked out. But yeah, I could have just used the goose and dealt four more damage or something. Yeah, that would have been better. If it didn't work out, I would have circled back and, you know, tried to figure out a different way. The problem was that I was running out of time, so I kind of just went with the first thing that I saw. And yeah, it worked out. That was nice. We didn't even get Behemoth and we still won on turn 4 or something. Maybe it was turn 5. Yeah, this is the problem, like not having Llanowar Elf like on the draw. I don't even think we can keep this hand. This is probably just not a keepable hand. Oh. In best of one, like the decks are usually a lot more aggressive. Like this, I mean, I just get owned by like a shock or something. I can go turn 2 Clan Caller, turn 3 this guy. It's already a 2/2. I have 2 legend. No, I'm not going to keep this. Okay, this is a million times better. I could just get rid of a land. Yeah, let's get rid of the land. Overgrown 2, interesting. Yeah, there's like it's night and day having Llanowar Elf. I'm kind of banking on this surviving, but I also have some redraws with this. Please don't cry of Crenario me. I could also turn off the sounds. Alright, there we go. Heartless Act. That is rather unfortunate, but we can still play cards. Yeah, this is unusually loud. Yeah, this is not going to be a great matchup if they have sweepers. Like if they have Extinction Event, for example, that would be pretty bad. I guess we're just gonna attack. I can just get 6 mana, play all of it, and hope they don't have a sweeper. I don't really think I have a better line anyways. I could play both of these and attack for 9, and I don't have to play this stuff. But then maybe I just don't beat like Nissa, for example. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this. Black is going to get so much better with Fatal Push. I think that's just one of the best removal spells of all time. I still can't believe I lost the blue-red match by playing Bonecrusher Giant. I'm like, oh my god, my opponent thinks for a minute, then plays Extinction Event. Are you kidding me? Wait, did they... Oh, I guess they... still wasn't all that great for them. All right, well, take 15. That's pretty good. This is definitely an upgrade for the Elves deck, just because it's like another menacing that doesn't cost 8 mana like Crater Hoof. It makes your Archdruids better and stuff like that. But it's just not Land War Elf. Like, turn 1, you just really need to play Elvish Mystic Land War Elf, that kind of card. And Gilded Goose just isn't the same. Hydra Krasis, that doesn't do it, I don't think. All right. GG's. All right, before my next game, I would like to mention that Ultimate Guard has... Not only do they have the best product for... And I do mean that sincerely, for gamers and all your, you know, deck boxes and everything you need. They do have an Argive 800 product that is coming out in a few days, and I'm going to use it to sleeve my, to put my cube into it. It does come out on the 13th of November, I believe. You should definitely pay attention to Ultimate Guard's Twitter, as they usually have a lot of really cool giveaways with the new product. Usually just some kind of fun stuff with giveaways, you know, mention your, you know, some cool experience or some kind of tag your gamer friend, and then they just give away a bunch of really sweet products. So specifically for cubing, this is going to be really cool. Or for the archive or boulder deck for the Sidewinders and boulder deck boxes, I think it can hold like 8 of them. So check it out. Ultimate Guard is a really, really good company, and I'm really happy that we get sponsored by them, because they do make the best gaming product. Yeah, check it out. Just pay attention to Ultimate Guard's Twitter. I think that's probably the easiest to pay attention to keep up with all the new product, including all the sweet giveaways. What can you? Oh, do you want to find the Elves list? I can put it on Stream Decker. It is from RelaxMTG on Twitter. Andrew Schneider, I believe. I hope I'm not getting the name wrong. I just noticed it on Twitter when I was going through. I was looking for some historic stuff, and I just came across this list. And I believe Andrew took it to rank number 1, just playing best of 1 historic, which is really, really cool. This is one of those hands where, again, Land of War Elf would make this hand absolutely great. Elisiris Shepherd, not quite the same. Can I keep this? I mean, all right, let's do it for science. Yorion should not be the fastest deck in the world. Let's just do it for science. I don't even know if I start with Gilded Goose. I can't even use it on turn 2, really. I mean, I still have to play it, I think. At least it's going to trick my opponent, I think. I could draw, but I think I would rather start at... Oh, wait, I don't have an elf. Never mind. I really don't want to have to use the Gilded Goose on just to play the Shepherd. Like, I think I'm just rather going to wait for a turn where I can activate Castle. So, like, one more turn. Next turn, I'll cast Shepherd Elite or something. And the turn after, I can activate Shepherd if I want to. Then it would actually be 20 damage, so... Oh, probably... Actually, that kills my Goose. That's good. I don't really mind. Don't really mind too much. What up, Alex? Welcome, everybody. Welcome. We're playing the best of one Elves deck from RelaxMTG on Twitter. The number one ranked historic player in best of one. Playing a strike without the new cards. The new cards come out on the 11th, I think, in 2 days. I'm really excited for that. If you guys don't know what Etherworks Marvel does, I do suggest you go check it out, because that card, you're gonna be seeing a lot of that card in your future. Wait, is this legend? Oh my god. For a second I thought that this was legendary and I thought that I messed up. So Archdruid Shepherd means if I untap with Archdruid, I can just win. This means that I can just draw a land to try to win, and they wouldn't be able to really stop me with a removal spell because I have two Shepherds. I do like playing three creatures a lot more than two. So one of the two cards has to be a land. Let's just go for this. I don't know if this is right. More free Willamox. Yeah, you're going to see a lot of that stuff. I think the other energy cards are going to be good enough. Oh, for sure. Like, that deck was, like, it doesn't really matter what the other energy cards do. Like, as long as they, like, interact with the opponent. Like, cards like Harness Lightning and Rogue Refiner, they just make sure that you survive a little bit longer. Even the stupid Puzzle Knot. I remember playing Standard and thinking... Yeah, this is bad. We're going to lose this very badly. And thinking, yeah, Puzzle Knot, there's no way that card is going to be good in this deck, right? Well, as it turns out, it does give you 6 energy. So, or 7 even, I don't even remember. Yeah, okay. Okay, bro. We are playing an anti-creature deck. That is probably not going to be AW. I mean, I guess... Everything can happen. They didn't put Yorion back into their hand, which is weird. I'll just play my land, I don't know. Yeah, okay. 6. They can't really Yorion me next turn, but it is not looking good. They named... Oh yeah, my opponent's name is Sparky. I didn't even realize that. Are you sure about Marvel? Yeah, I mean, it's a 4 mana artifact. I can basically win the game. So it doesn't get hit by either Gust. It doesn't really care about your midrange stuff you played before. Like, you just play Ulamog on turn 4. Like, that is pretty good. It doesn't really get much better than that. I mean, you could win with Muxus sometimes on turn 3 with Goblins, but also getting to Ulamog people on turn 4. Not the worst. Okay. Okay, bro. You farmed a creature deck. Good job. Can't be mad. I think this is what you can do in best of one. You can just play an anti-creature deck and probably just farm all the aggro decks. And yeah, that deck is probably almost most of it standard legal. Is the 1 mana counter target colors spell in historic? I think it is in Kaladesh. I'm not 100% sure, but I think so. Kaladesh remastered card image gallery. Ceremonious rejection. Yeah, it's in Kaladesh remastered. But one thing that I think is better is Gravedigger's Cage. Like, to my understanding, Cage stops you from playing the cards off of Marvel, because it doesn't like reveal or something. You actually take a look at the top 6 cards. Again, we lose the die roll again. We don't have land or elf. I think we just have to mulligan this. As like, it sounds bad. Like, you kind of just, you know, you draw a reasonable amount of lands and spells, and you have company. Like, you have the good cards you want to draw in your deck. But without land or elf, you just cannot keep this hand. This is the same hand, but with one less card. Well, I guess now I kind of have to keep. I don't want to gamble with two companies with just two lands. I could have ditched this probably because I don't even have a. Yeah, maybe I should have gone to five. I don't know. Ooh, Elf Mirror. Yeah, like it's such a big difference if you have elf or not. Like being on the draw and not having an elf, I don't think I can possibly win this game. Oh, this is Gruul. Okay, then maybe there's some world when they have a slow draw or something. That's why I like playing with sideboards, so I don't get tilted by losing the dial. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oof. I don't really want to have to play the elite, but I also don't really want to not play it and then just die. My opponent plays questing these, I'm taking 10. This draw really didn't work out. Maybe I could have multi five, but it's a good hand. Like if you draw like one of the goose elf, that's kind of it, I guess. Maybe I should have gone to five. The worst part is playing this does not really accomplish anything. I could play this guy turn three, then play elite and archer. Yeah, I'm just gonna hope I don't get questing beasted. Rip wild cards. All right, take six is not the worst. I mean, there's like a 0.5% chance I can ever win this game. Maybe if they have three Ember Cleaves, they never draw another red mana, something like that. Nope, there's the red mana. And we dead, right? 4, 8, 10, 12. I guess I'm not dead yet. All right, I am dead to cleave. I'm not saying I would, you know, play this deck in a Pro Tour right now, but I would, if you're looking for a fun deck, and like Elves is a really, really popular tribe. Can you use your contacts at Watsi and delete Urion? Yeah, unfortunately, not really. I think this format is actually kind of okay. I don't think I have outs in my deck, by the way. So this makes it, this is going to make it a 3-3, but this is going to also make it a 3-3. And I can play Company. Wait, was there a better way to do it? No. I mean, I have to hit something really insane in this. I don't even know what. I guess I have to play it on my own. No, if I wait, I can do it on my opponent's turn and block. I have to basically reveal double elite to make this a 7-7, then I don't die and have enough blockers. If I do it on my turn, I don't get to block with this, but I can find visionaries and still play something. This does not help. No. This format's still better than what it was before. If I do it after blockers, I still die? Not really. If I, like, this is going to grow. There's going to be elves coming. Like, if I find two elite... Oh, wait. Yeah, you're right. Then I can't block with the creatures. Yep. And then I guess I can find goose. But then I don't have enough mana to gain life. Is there any way to survive this? Block. Yeah, no. Even two elites, I still die exactly. I make this a 7-7. If I do it right away, I die for sure. So I don't know. Let's see what happens. Wait, can I play something before we deal first strike damage? Elite and Archdruid. Would that have been better before blockers? That's still okay if I... No. Sure. No Rexage. You can play Rexage in the sideboard, but since this is best of one, there is no best Rexage in the main. They're just putting it on the elf. What do we get? See, I was right about the double Embercleave. They did have double Embercleave. They didn't have red mana. So at least we did find a way to try to possibly win. But they're putting it on the unblock guy, right? Yeah, I can deal with that. Yeah, there is nothing I can do. Yeah. All right, well, GG's. GG's. It was close. If we had Llanowar Elf, I think we would have still won. I devoted to Sheriff. We can play later. Yeah, I think four games are enough. Like best of one is a lot like high variance. I didn't really enjoy that format too much, but hey, elves is a popular tribe, and if you're good at drawing Llanowar Elves and winning die rolls, then I think this is a fine deck to play.